Tarantino because my parents did not say that. My grandparents are really conservative people in like almost every area of their life, except in the bedroom, because my grandpa will choke my grandma when they're in bed together. And they're not part of like this new age, everybody has a kink and accept it, I love to be choked kind of thing. They're like, he chokes her because he has PTSD. And he'll have flashbacks in the middle of the night where to Vietnam, where he thinks she's a Viet Cong. And he'll start choking her. He didn't even fight in Vietnam. That's just how bad of a decade that was for that man. No, my grandparents are a lot kinkier people than I am. Sex is something that's like built up from the time you're like very little, like you're 5, you're like, don't do that. And you're like 12, you're like, I want to do that. And then you get to 18, and then it happens. And then you're like, well, what the fuck do I do now? That's all my life's been building towards. Like, it changes some people. Like, I'm not a virgin, but I still identify as virgin. Like, it's on the tax forms, it says Caucasian virgin. That's what it says. But it definitely, like, there's some dudes, like, they have to become a different person. My roommate in college, he had sex, like, before he had sex, he was autistic, I think. But he was Rain Man before, like, he's like, hello, good evening, Connor, I'm gonna go do my studies now. And then he fucked this girl, and I know he fucked her because we were in a dorm room, and I was hiding under the covers watching because I wanted to see how autistic people have sex. And then the next day he's like, what's up, man? Hey, you wanna go play some Frisbee? You wanna go play some Ultimate with me and Amanda? I'm like, no. What the fuck happened to you? How did it change you that much? He's like, I did it. And I was like, great, what's next? I lived in Alaska for a while, and like I think like it made me question my sexuality because it's all dudes up there. It's all burly men wearing flannel and they all have beards. And they don't wear it ironically. They're not like, I've got flannel, I've got a fucking H&M. Like, they wear it because it's practical, because they need it, because they'll die if they don't. And they're like, it's all dudes. It's all men. I saw 3 women the whole time I was up there. And so for about 2 months, I thought I was gay because I was attracted to this guy I worked with. I worked at a pool. I was a lifeguard in Alaska. There's 2 pools in Alaska for the people that want to be cold the rest of the year. And they were sitting there, like, I was at work and I was watching them, and I like started to think I was gay because I had developed a phallic fixation around watching this guy put his whistle in his mouth, and I just imagined it was my dick going into his mouth. And
oh my gosh.
But I did. He wasn't like a cool guy. Like I started to question my 2 weeks of being gay because this guy was in addition to being a lifeguard, he was also a world-class frisbee player and a weed dealer. Like, he played frisbee golf, and he'd show me, I knew it wasn't me because he was showing me videos of him playing frisbee golf on YouTube at the World Championships, and he had 67 views on these videos of him throwing a rubber disc into it. Chain net. And he's like, hey man, wasn't that cool? I'm like, yeah, I want you to hold me. Like, I miss companionship. That's what I need up here. But like, because when you're young and you're not confident in who you are, like, you'll believe anything. But you feel something, like, ooh, maybe that's me. Or like, if someone tells you something, you'll pick it up. You're like, yes, for sure, I believe that. But like, when I was in high school, when I was 16, some kid told me I was autistic. And he didn't tell me in a way that you'd expect like another 16-year-old to tell someone else that they're autistic. He wasn't like, hey, you're a fucking retard. He was really sincere. When he told me he thought I was autistic because he read a BuzzFeed article called 20 Signs Your Child Has Autism. He told me in the most sincere way possible. He said, hey, I read this thing about you, and I know it's you because you yell a lot. You say really rude things to people, and you have a hard time making eye contact. And the whole time he's saying this, I'm like, God damn it, fuck this kid. But then I thought about him, like, this diagnosis, this can help me. Because my dad would yell at me a lot. And when he'd yell at me, he would go something like this, like, doing that? Yeah. I noticed. It wasn't just you. You guys remember the Applebee's?
Yes.
I fucking love Applebee's. That was my mom, because my mom worked at Applebee's, and she'd bring home like chicken wings and beer, and I'd eat the chicken wings, and then she'd get super drunk off like the two beers she snuck from her job. She eventually got fired because she was fucking a terrible bartender. I like Applebee's. It's not like people in Minneapolis like shit on Applebee's, but usually it's an opinion coming from people wearing cyclist hats and military boots. And like, that's not an original opinion to not like Applebee's. And they always say, well, it's not a unique dining experience. It's like everywhere else. Yeah, well, I like knowing that I can go to any small town in the Midwest and see the same picture of the Big Bopper and have the same high school waitress named Krista who doesn't know if she wants to go to college in the big city or take care of her ailing father. Like, that's an experience that I look forward to. And they say it's not a unique dining experience. Well, what the fuck is a unique dining experience? Why don't you go out to the middle of the woods without supplies for 4 weeks and then come back and tell me how your buddy Travis is liberated? Cannibalism is a unique dining experience that only you and the Donner Party can share. That's what a unique dining experience is. Like, it's good fucking food you at a reasonable price for you can bring your family to, but also have a drink. And also, it's supported, like, it helps supply my family with food. Yeah. So you guys don't like Applebee's?
No.
Or just, like, my take on Applebee's? Or you hate Applebee's? That's probably it. You guys all wear cyclist hats? Is that the thing?
And combat boots.
And combat boots. I think I've seen you wear combat boots. Is that...